So dear friends, we are all set. Now, our today's presentation is ultrasound of urinary bladder. We'll discuss about technique, how to do ultrasound of adult urinary bladder. We will look also, some fetal urinary bladder, normal and abnormal. And in our presentation, we emphasize the normal and abnormal urinary bladder of adult. Now, ultrasound of the urinary bladder, we use protocol, some normal protocol. Ultrasound is an important tool for assessing bladder wall. We can look the wall thickening. We can assess whether there is any trabeculation. We can diagnose whether any normal and abnormal masses, calculus, or any foreign body within the urinary bladder. We can assess the post and pre-micturation volumes, and we can also look surroundings of the urinary bladder. We can assess the buse, whether there is any small calculus within the buse, or is there any diverticulum or any Now, our requirements, we use the full bladder as an acoustic window to assess the prostate in males and gynecological structure in females. Our limitation is extensive pelvic scarring or overlying bowel gas. If the bladder is not sufficiently distended, pathology may be hidden by the folds. On the other hand, over distension of urinary bladder also create some problem. We can miss in some pathology. Now, regarding patient preparation, the patient must present with a full bladder. 2 hours prior to appointment, the patient should empty their bladder. For the next hour, they should drink at least 1 liter of water. And we use a curvilinear probe, 3 to 5 megahertz, with color Doppler. If you have got color Doppler facility, it is well. But if you have not color Doppler facility, you can also scan very nicely the urinary bladder. Now, about scanning techniques. This is the patient lying supine, and this is the transducer. We place the transducer in longitudinal plane, and the slide of ultrasound is urinary bladder is like this, and this is in long section. And at long section, we rotate the transducer 90 degrees. And this is the axial plane or the transverse plane. This from long section, when you rotate the transducer 90 degrees, this comes to transverse section. And in every ultrasound examination, we do ultrasound at least in 2 orthogonal plane to confidence, to increase our confidence about diagnosis. And this is the short section of urinary bladder. And we can look the ureteric jet by putting the color box. This is the left ureteric jet. This is the right ureteric jet. So if you have not color Doppler facility, you can still see the in grayscale the flow of urine into the bladder from the use the junction. and this is the normal anatomy of urinary bladder normal scan. This is the long section and this is the anal section. The urinary bladder wall, we can assess the bladder wall, thickness of the bladder wall, is there any trabeculation within the bladder. We can assess whether there is any diverticulum, or we can assess any other pathology within the bladder. Now, the thickness of the bladder wall, vary with the degree of distension, but should always be approximate the same all around the bladder. Understand it? A normal bladder wall is less than 3 millimeter in thickness. About bladder volume, it's almost impossible to give an exact measurement for the volume of the human bladder. That is, everyone's ability to hold a certain amount of urine differs. A healthy adult bladder can hold up to 16 ounces, that is 2 cups of urine comfortably. How frequently it fills depends on how much excess water your body is trying to get rid of. A completely full bladder is capable of holding approximately 1 liter of fluid. Ordinarily, the urges to urinate occurs when the bladder contains about 200 ml of urine. The desire to micturate begins at around a content of 400 ml, but it can be voluntarily overridden until the content reaches 600 to 800 ml. Then, now, before going to detailed discussion of adult urinary bladder, normal and abnormal, I would like to show you two of my cases of fetal urinary bladder. One is normal and other is abnormal. And this is a fetus of about 18 weeks size, and this is the urinary bladder. So look the cliff. This is the urinary bladder. And this is the 15 weeks old fetus. And this is the urinary bladder. And around the urinary bladder, the two umbilical arteries are there. This is the kidneys also. And this is the umbilical artery. Here is the kidneys. And this is the abnormal one. And this is a baby fetus of 15 and a half weeks. Is large urinary bladder. So this is a megacystis in urinary bladder. Now we look the normal abnormal pathologies of adult urinary bladder. We can diagnose, is there any trabeculation, whether there is any diverticulum, whether there is calculus, or whether there is an ureterocele, and we can also assess or look, is there any neoplasm. So we can briefly discuss each by one by one. First, the trabeculation. The trabeculation of the urinary bladder is seen as folds of hypertrophied bladder mucosa and bladder smooth muscle. This is the trabeculation, saw-like appearance, sawtooth-like appearance in the urinary bladder. The bladder trabeculation has been graded from 0 to 3, and the grade 0 is no trabeculation. That is the normal urinary bladder. The walls are smooth, and that is no trabeculation. The grade 1 is mild, area affected is less than half of the bladder wall, and the depth of the trabeculation is less than 5 millimeters. Grade 2 or moderate trabeculations are affected is greater than half of the urinary bladder, and the depth of the trabeculation is 5 to 10 millimeters. And the grade 3, that is the severe trabeculation, the affected area is greater than half of the urinary bladder wall, and the depth of the trabeculation is greater than 10 millimeters. So, trabeculation grading, no trabeculation, grade 1. That's normal urinary bladder. Grade 1 is affected less than half of the bladder wall, and the depth of the trabeculation is less than 5. And moderate or the grade 2 is greater than half affected area, but the trabeculation, depth of the trabeculation is up to 10 millimeter, 5 to 10 millimeter. But if increases up more than 10, then this is the severe trabeculation. Our second topic of pathology is the bladder diverticulum. A bladder diverticulum is a pouch in the bladder wall that is a person either be born with, that is the congenital variety, or dead later, that is the acute variety. And this is the urinary bladder. This is a big diverticulum with a neck communicating each other. And this is the other types of diverticulum, multiple small diverticulum throughout the urinary bladder wall. And this is what I have shown you earlier. Excuse me. A congenital bladder diverticulum forms when some of the bladder lining pokes through a weak part in the bladder wall. A congenital diverticulum is most often found in childhood, and there is often only one pouch, and there is they often don't need to be treated. A acquired bladder diverticula are most often caused by a block in the bladder outlet. With acquired diverticula many pouches of often forms, and these are most often seen in older men who tend to get bladder outlets block more often. We get it sometimes in enlarged prostate patients. So this is one of my case. This is the large diverticulum, and look, this is the scan, and this is the cliff. The urine flows to and fro between urinary bladder and diverticulum. Look again, and this is the neck, through neck, fluid goes to and fro. So when we measured preboidal scan of urinary bladder, we get it about 121 cc, and the diverticulum, the volume of the diverticulum is 36 cc. But when we ask the patient to void, after post-void, the bladder volume is decreases, but the diverticulum volume is increased. It is about 47 ml. Now our third pathology is the bladder calculi. Bladder calculi occurs either from migrated, that is renal calculi, or it may occurs through urinary stasis. Bladder calculi can be divided into primary and the secondary stones. Primary stones form de novo in the bladder. Secondary stones are either from renal calculi, which have migrated down into the bladder, or from concretion on the foreign materials as an example, urinary catheters. On ultrasound, bladder calculi are mobile, echogenic, and shadow distally. They may be associated with bladder wall thickening due to inflammation. And here is a calculus moves with posture change of the patient. And when we put color, that is a artifact, color comet tail artifact or twinkle artifact, we can get it. And it increases our diagnostic confidence. So this is the slide and this is the look. This is the cliff, the movement of the calculus. And it gives posterior acoustic shadowing. And the shadow also goes along with the calculus. So mobile structures giving acoustic shadowing is the calculus. And on putting color, we get the color comet tail artifact or twinkle artifact. This is another case. This is a stent and this is a blood clot. It does not give acoustic shadowing, but it moves on posture. This gives shadowing from the foreign body, that is the stent, not a calculus. And here is, as I mentioned, we can get some pathology around the bladder wall, that is tiny calculus outside the bladder in the region of Buse. And this is the small calculus. And when you put color box, this is the twinkle artifact or color comet tail artifact. And this is the slides of calculus. This is another case. This is the shadow of calculus, the twinkle artifact on calculus. And this is another case, quite large calculus giving acoustic shadowing on grayscale and on color Doppler giving color comet tail artifact. Look here, look again. This is the color comet tail artifact. This is the ureteric jet from right ureter. And at left, views a, this is the calculus giving color comet tail artifact. Here, this is the right kidney, mild hydronephrosis, the left kidney, and there is a small calculus within the right views. So how do we get some splaying of renal sinus or mild hydronephrosis? We look, we should look carefully the contralateral, ipsilateral Buse. This is the Buse calculus. Now we can proceed to our next topic, that is the ureteral seal. And this is a large ureteral seal within the urinary bladder. This is a schematic drawing of ureteral seal. This is the ureter enters into the bladder, and this is the ureteral seal. This is the bladder wall, and this is the schematic drawing of ureteral seal. By definition, a ureteral seal is a sacculation of the terminal portion of the ureter. A ureteral seal is a birth defect associated with duplex collecting system. Sometimes, in most of the time, there may be duplex collecting system on that side of the, that is ipsilateral side of the ureteral seal. So we should carefully scan the kidneys. When we get bifid renal sinus, we may suspect that may have duplicate ureter. Ureteral seal by demographics present during adulthood, usually simple ureteral seal, and present during childhood, ectopic ureteral seal. And the females are more affected than the male. Occurs about 1 in 500 to 1 in 4,000 people, more in female than male. bilateral in 10%. Ectopic erythrocele are 4 times common than those that are intravesical. Delayed canalization of the chawala membrane during embryogenesis, which causes obstruction of the uteric orifice. This is the etiology of embryologic etiology of the erythrocele. Chawala membrane is a primitive membrane that separates the uteric bud from the developing urogenital sinus. And it is a non-inherited disorder. So according to classification of erythrocele, this is erythrocele according to position, intravesical erythrocele, prolapsing erythrocele. According to location of the erythrocele, simple and ectopic. And according to renal collecting system, single system, duplicate system. Intravesical erythrocele, according to position, completely contained within the urinary bladder. Actually, this variety we are often found, but we missed the other one, that is extravesical and small calculus, ectopic calculus. Prolapsing erythrocele, this is the extravesical. The erythrocele prolapses into the bladder neck, may cause bladder neck obstruction, and the urethra may emerge from the urethral orifice. And this is the CT scan, and this is the photograph of erythrocele urethra. According to the location of uteric orifice, simple, orthotopic, about 25%, and ectopic, about 75%. The uteric orifice is located at its normal anatomical position. And in ectopic, the uteric orifice is located outside its normal anatomic position, that is in the region of the bladder trigone. According to the renal collecting system, single system erythrocele, that is erythrocele draining single collecting system. Single system erythrocele are usually simple. Duplex system erythrocele, erythrocele draining the upper moiety of the duplex kidney and inserts below the medial to the urethra, draining the lower moiety. Duplex system erythrocele are usually ectopic. And in books about erythrocele, there is a sign known as the cobra sign, and which is the cobra head. This is the cobra. So this is the cobra sign we can get. Complication of erythrocele, first infection, the most common presentation. Obstruction, we may get read hydronephrosis. Stone formation, hematuria, incontinence of urine, acute bladder neck obstruction. And this is calculus within the erythrocele. I have found in my practice about 3 cases of calculus within the erythrocele. And this is the drawing, schematic drawing of erythrocele within the bladder. And by IVP, cobra head appearance, we can get associated hydronephrosis, associated complete duplex kidney. Actually, by contrast enhanced IVP and by ultrasound urography, we can diagnose the duplex kidney. Excuse me. Associated complete duplex kidney with hydronephrosis of the upper moiety. This is the dropping lily sign. This is the dropping lily sign of erythrocele. On ultrasound, cyst within a cyst appearance. Dilated urethra draining into the erythrocele. Associated hydronephrosis we can found, and associated duplex kidney by seeing duplex, by seeing sightseeing, by feed canal sinus. So this is again, look, the cobra sign, large cobra head sign. This is the IVP, cobra head duplex system of the urinary bladder. This is the normal kidney and normal ureter. This is the duplex collecting system. This is a bilateral urethral, but the collecting system is single. Other some pathology, some rare pathology. This is a focal wall thickening of urinary bladder due to cystisomiasis. And cystisomiasis is usually not common in our country. And this is the hypoechic area, posterior bladder. And this is the patient gives history of periodic hematuria. Actually, the hematuria is on during her menstruation. So this is the clinical and ultrasound finding correlates. This is endometriosis. Cystitis. There are many causes of inflammation of the bladder wall, including infection, radiation, drugs, and trauma. The bladder appears sonographically normal in most cases, but may show thickening of its wall as a result of edema. The bladder mucosa is normally less than 3 millimeters thick when measured at full distension, and less than 5 millimeters thick when non-distended. So if we get more than 5 millimeters of wall thickness, we will suspect that the bladder wall is thickened. This is acute cystitis. Abnormally increased thickness of urinary bladder all around. And acute and chronic cystitis in a neurogenic bladder. These are the focal thickening. This is the cystitis, glandularis cystitis. And this is the eosinophilic cystitis. So we can, by ultrasound, we may say that there is a focal thickening of bladder wall, but when we culture the urine, we can get the pathological findings. Sometimes we may get the calcified bladder wall. Now some neoplasm of urinary bladder. Benign neoplasm include neomyoma, hemangioma, neurofibroma, and schwannoma. The tumors are of uncertain malignant potential, including paraganglioma, granular cell tumors, and perivascular epithelioid cell tumors. Leiomyoma of the urinary bladder is a rare benign, predominantly found in women, although men can also be affected. The most common presenting complaints of urinary voiding symptoms such as obstruction and irritation. An ultrasound typically shows a smooth walled homogeneous hypoechoic solid mass in the bladder with echogenic surface. This is the leiomyoma. Inverted papilloma of urinary bladder is a rare entity according to literature data. This disease is not malignant and has low recurrence rate. Inverted papilloma. Schwannoma, again, one of the rare tumor of urinary bladder, benign tumor of the urinary bladder. And this is the phacochromocytoma of urinary bladder. This is also very rare. Now the bladder's malignancy. Bladder cancer is any of several types of cancer arising from the epithelial cells, that is the urothelium of the urinary bladder. Rarely the bladder is involved by non-epithelial cancer such as lymphoma or sarcoma, but these are not ordinarily included in the colloquial term, bladder cancer. And it is a disease in which abnormally cell multiply without control of the bladders. The most common types of bladder cancer recapitulates the normal histology of the urothelium and is known as the transitional cell carcinoma, or the more common popularly urothelial cell carcinoma. 5-year cervical rates in the United States are around 77%. Squamous cell carcinoma, about 4%, post prognosis associated with chronic infection and irritation in underdeveloped nations associated with bladder infection by schistosomia hematobium. Adenocarcinoma is rare, that is 1% of cancer, most common in bladder ectopy, responded poorly to radiation therapy. And these are the carcinoma slides of carcinoma. This is the large irregular mass bladder wall, and on putting color the vessels. This is another multiple masses in the urinary bladder. This is again big mass occupying almost the whole lumen of the urinary bladder. This is the transitional cell carcinomas. This is the multiple patients. So, before concluding, before ending my today's presentation, I may conclude that we have discussed the technique of ultrasound of urinary bladder, how we prepare the patient, and what are the pathologies and how we diagnose these pathologies. And we also shows one clips of fetal urinary bladder, normal fetal urinary bladder, and a megacystis, that is abnormal urinary bladder. So with these few words, I conclude my today's presentation. Thank you all, hoping you enjoyed it.